This is the Hubble Space Telescope that has revolutionized how we look at the universe. And here is its successor, the James Webb Space Telescope. It's the largest and most powerful space telescope ever built, and it's about to launch later this month.
You could almost think of it as a telescope to complete this grand question of when did the first galaxies form.
Liftoff of the Space Shuttle Discovery with the Hubble Space Telescope, our window on the universe.
The once trailblazing Hubble telescope launched in 1990 and has been orbiting Earth ever since, capturing visuals like this, a composite of filtered and colorized images. Its ability to see light from billions of years ago has opened a window into early parts of the universe, but it could never see the very oldest galaxies. But now, the James Webb Telescope has the necessary technology to capture the earliest forming stars and planets, and possibly a glimpse into how life first began. The James Webb Telescope, named after the former NASA administrator, is one of the largest international scientific efforts in U.S. history.
Learning about the sky tells us more about how our planet, how we came to be.
For over three decades, Dr. Eric Smith has been innovating telescopes for NASA. After working on Hubble, he then spent the last 25 years developing Webb.
You can make the case that the history of 20th century astronomy was building ever larger telescopes to see ever farther galaxies.
The Hubble Space Telescope takes images of planets, stars, and galaxies some billions of light years away while staying in Earth's orbit where it can be repaired. Hubble primarily scans the cosmos in the same way our eyes process visible light, which enables it to view hotter, younger stars. Colder stars, which can be billions of years older, are less visible to Hubble. And this is where the James Webb Telescope will shine. Webb will observe the universe in a different way than Hubble, using primarily infrared light, which isn't visible to the human eye.
When you look in the infrared, you're studying things that are a little cooler. So you see cooler stars, of which there are many more than the hotter stars. It's also easier to detect faint things like planets and exoplanets.
Infrared light allows the telescope to unveil thick clouds of dust that surround galaxies and nebulae, revealing more detail and information about how stars and planets first formed. Here are two images of the same nebula that Hubble took, one using visible light and the other using infrared. But James Webb will be able to take infrared images with even more clarity and sensitivity than Hubble, and this will help it accomplish one of its core missions: looking back further in time to the earliest galaxies that formed after the Big Bang.
The way Webb will be used to see these first galaxies, you take pictures of different patches of the sky and you count the number of faint galaxies you see down to a certain brightness level. And at some point, you would expect to see a cliff saying there are just no more galaxies below this.
The very faintest objects that Webb will see are some of the oldest lights in the universe, revealing a window back in time. And what powers this new telescope to see galaxies that formed billions of years ago is cutting-edge technology. The $10 billion James Webb Telescope is 100 times more powerful than Hubble, and much of that power comes from its massive primary mirror, which is over 21 feet wide, nearly three times larger than Hubble's. It will be the largest ever put in space. And part of what makes it so powerful is what the mirror segments are composed of.
They're made of beryllium, which is a very lightweight material that's stable at the very cold temperatures we want the telescope to operate at. And then, because we want to study the infrared part of the spectrum, we want to have the smooth surface coated with something that reflects infrared light really well, and that substance is gold. It's actually a very thin layer. It's only about 1,000 atoms thick. If you scraped up all the gold that was in Webb, it would only be about the size of a golf ball.
Webb also has advanced sensors and scientific instruments on board to help scientists analyze the cosmos. One instrument is the near-infrared spectrograph, which is designed to determine what kind of elements or chemical compounds are in distant parts of space.
In the Big Bang, we had hydrogen and helium, pretty much nothing else. Everything else was made in stars. So if you see a spectrum of an object that has pretty much just only hydrogen and helium, then you know you're seeing one of the first objects to be formed.
And this is key. One goal of Webb is to give insight into when it would have been possible for habitable planets to first form, which could hold clues into how the universe and life first began. For Webb sensors and scientific instruments to work, they need to be kept cool, which is why a huge sunshield with layers the thickness of a plastic bag is used. And to see some of the universe's oldest galaxies, Webb will also need a crystal clear view. This is why the telescope will travel about 1 million miles away from Earth towards deep space, where it cannot be repaired like Hubble can.
Most of our space telescopes orbit the Earth nearby. So why do we have to go 1 million miles away? Primarily, it's to be far from the Earth, which itself is a very bright object in the infrared.
As advanced as Webb is, it won't be the last telescope to search for life beyond Earth. A recent report from the National Academy of Sciences recommended that an even larger telescope should be designed in the next decade to look for life on exoplanets, opening the window of possibility for finding extraterrestrial life.